Everybody knows about the bird. You got it. 1970 Superbird. Now, everybody knows them. You see them rolling down the road or in the local garage. What's so special about a Superbird? Well, other than the fact they couldn't be sold in 1970, now you can't touch one for under $200,000. This car, I've got my gloves on, represents the 12th rarest muscle car in the world, the 1970 Hemi 4-speed Superbird. With me on this white glove special is Tommy White. Tommy represents this car. Now, Tommy, tell us why this blue Hemi Superbird is so rare.
Well, here you've got a car that they've only made two B5 blue with white interior 4-speed Hemi cars. This is one of the two. This is the survivor. This is just under 20,000 miles, original car. Yes, there's some little blams. There's a little scratches and some dings. It's a survivor.
Let everyone know, what exactly does the word survivor mean?
Survivor means as it was originally as built, with original paint, original parts, original as possible, aside from oil, maybe a filter, or certain things that got changed during the tune-up stage in the life of its car, with just under 20,000 miles.
It hasn't been restored. It
has not been restored at all.
Okay. And when you're ready.
I'm rolling.
Tommy, take us through the interior of this Hemi Superbird.
See the gauges, you got 150 speedo, you got a tick-tock tach, which means a clock built into the tachometer. See the 4-speed shifter? That gets a big kick. A lot of people see that big old tall shifter sticking out of the floor.
Now, that shifter had a name. What was it called?
Well, that's a Hurst shifter. And that
pistol grip.
It's a pistol grip Hurst shifter. And they were short and long. That's the long ones, because that came in the B-bodies and the short one was in the Cuda. See the white bucket seats? Not much else as far as option. Pretty much standard for this particular bird.
But a lot of the birds did have a console bench seat. This being rare because it does have the buckets and it does have the 4-speed.
Correct. There's a lot of bench seats put in birds.
And they couldn't get rid of them.
And they couldn't get rid of them.
And now they're worth, you know, like I said, $200,000-$400,000.
Yes. The story is the longest bird on the market was over 2 years at a new car dealership, and they had to take the wing off to sell it.
You ready? Tommy, obviously, the most distinctive thing about any Superbird is that is that great wing. Tell us, how did that thing come into play? Why was it even there?
Well, that wing was aerodynamically designed for the car to run at Talladega and super speedways. The Superbird was built for Richard Petty. That lured him back because Ford had him in the 1970 series in their NASCAR. He started with Dodge in 69, but Dodge wasn't going to continue with a wing car. So Plymouth built this specially for him to lure him back. Of course, they had to build 1,500 examples to go racing, and there was just over 1,900 of these things built. This was designed for Richard Petty, and of course, these are the street models that were hard to sell at that time because they were ahead of their time for shape and configuration.
And 1 year later, NASCAR outlawed them. That's the end of the Superbird.
Yes, because they set the speed record at Talladega just over 200 miles an hour, which stood up until about 8 years ago as the fastest production car on a NASCAR track.
And there it is, right there, the business. Would you look at the size of that thing? My gosh, the 426 Hemi, which makes this car so rare and special. Tommy, tell us again, the Hemi motor, what is it all about?
Well, the 426 Hemi, 425 horse advertised, closer to 475 in real life. And that was the business end of the highest end for performance from Chrysler. And that Hemi engine drove a lot of cars in the performance circle.
Now, let's talk a little bit about these things on the fenders. They were for the NASCAR on this car. They're not functional, but tell the people, what are they?
Those actually were outlets for tire. The turbulence that was generated in the wheel wells was an escape to get them out. And they just left them as that, as a prototype piece for the streetcar for look. They're not even functional.
Not even functional. Doesn't matter. That makes the Superbird the Superbird. And there you have it, folks. Tommy, thanks again for your time. We really appreciate it. There it is, the 1970 Hemi Superbird, your 12th rarest muscle car in the world.